No more testing, no more practice. This is the real deal. And it's make or break here at Albert Park, home of the Australian Grand Prix since 1996. And home to round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 16 corners and 3.3 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles an hour. The close proximity of the barriers makes accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. Here we are then, Formula One in 2020. The fight for the World Championship all starts here today. Mercedes on the hunt for a seventh consecutive title. They'll have Ferrari and Red Bull to contend with along the way. Williams struggled to find their feet last year. They'll be hoping for a stronger start this time around. And what a wonder of the Renault-powered cars. Will they be able to step forward? Maybe even onto the podium on a regular basis. Plenty to discuss then with Anthony Davidson. He's out of hibernation too, and alongside me in the commentary box once again.
It's good to be back, Crofty. Let's hope for some good racing today. We can't know at this point how competitive these teams are relative to each other, but hopefully nobody is able to run and hide. We want to see these drivers pushing to the limit all the way to the checkered flag.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have a Mercedes, Albon, Charles Leclerc and Verstappen, Sainz, Perez, Ricciardo and Lando Norris, Stroll, Ocon, Daniel Kvyat and Gasly, Magnussen, Grosjean, Kimi Raikkonen and George Russell, Giovinazzi and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Alright, everybody, welcome back to a brand new episode on my channel. My name is Gaming, and welcome back to another F1 2020 video. Today, it's race day here in Australia, and also I don't know why the grid didn't show up. But yeah, so if you're watching today's video, leave a like and subscribe. And let's get this first race in F1 on the way.
We're looking good so far. battery charge is high. Let's use that overtake button more. Clear. Easy. We don't want to see you take each other out. We expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards. Spare energy, use your overtake button. Boxing this lap, give us the best in lap you can. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Lewis is in for a stop. Okay, good work. Great pass. Our gap to the car in front is 3.0 seconds. Car behind you has just fitted the hard tires. Car behind, running hards.
So from lap 12 to around 24-25, not much happened. George Russell and the rest of the field that didn't pitted, and I went to P2, and that's pretty much it. So yeah, let's get to the last 5 laps, or to lap 25.
Okay, clear. Tire concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Second place, you're in second place. Lewis is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 34.6 seconds. They're on old hards. Sainz is behind you. Less than a second separate you. They're on old hards. The pit window is open. Pit window currently open. 5 laps till the end. expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Green flag. We'll be right back. was far too aggressive. Clean passes only. We don't want a penalty. Two laps of fuel remaining. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a good finish. Well done.
Another superb Australian Grand Prix comes to an end, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. After an incredible performance, Lewis Hamilton secures the top spot in the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Alright, so that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed, leave a like and subscribe. And then surprise, the two McLarens actually got P3 and P4. But yeah, so if you watched today's video, leave a like and subscribe. While I'm at it, go ahead and check out my Discord and Twitch, link down below. And yeah, this is Gaming signing off. I'll see you in a brand new video. Peace.